There's too many ways to create content with ChatGPT, and looking for that perfect prompt is a waste of time. Instead, you can start by using templates, custom prompts with browser extensions, and even get data from search engines, use speech recognition, and much more. In this video, I will show you 10 of the best ChatGPT Chrome extensions that will allow you to churn out content and save your valuable time. There's hundreds of ChatGPT extensions, however, I've gone ahead and picked what are, in my opinion, the 10 best, so that you don't waste time trying a lot of different extensions. Most of them are free, but some of them do have some limits or caveats, since the companies can get into paid territory and then they need to pay for the ChatGPT API access. The first extension is Keywords Everywhere, which also works well for SEO and keyword research. It has a great keyword strategy template. You can install it on Chrome or Firefox. After installing the extension, an icon will appear on ChatGPT with a templates option. You can click on that icon to see the templates and then go to SEO, keyword research, keyword strategy template, write a seed keyword, and if you want to use that same prompt, you can copy paste it to use on other chatbots. You would then execute the prompt and you will get an organized table with keywords, categories, and search intent, but also titles and a description. There are also many other prompts you can check out. Now let's check out the second extension, which is YouTube Summary, ChatGPT and Claude by Glasp. This extension will allow you to generate a summary of any YouTube video. It is very useful for competitive research, getting content ideas, summarizing your own videos to write descriptions, social media posts and so on, or even for learning and taking notes from videos. After installing the extension, you can go to YouTube and click on any video. Now you will see a new transcript and summary option at the top right. Make sure you have an open session or tab in ChatGPT, otherwise the extension will redirect you to the login screen. To summarize a video, all you need to do is click on that ChatGPT icon and a new window will open up on ChatGPT with a summary of your video. By default, it will try to sum up a video into 5 bullet points, but you can change that on the extension settings. You can even use follow-up prompts that will show up on the bottom near the ChatGPT prompt bar, which makes it quite easy to repurpose the content that you've just got from that summary. It's also possible to change the summary strategy and assign a keyword shortcut to use it. ChatGPT Sidebar is an all-in-one AI tool that can be used for different purposes. It includes a AI chat function, AI writing, an ask tool with built-in templates, an OCR, which allows you to extract text and numbers from images, a grammar checker, Painter, and ChatPDF, which is an AI tool that reads PDF files for you. There's also a YouTube summary tool that will allow you to summarize video transcripts from YouTube, just like the previous extension that I've mentioned. While researching on Google, Sidebar will also pop up and it will give you extra information about what you enter in the search bar, like asking ChatGPT what the topic is about, getting related keywords, or even turning keywords into questions. It's a great extension, but it only has 30 free credits per day. For more extensive use, you may want to consider getting a paid plan or looking into other extensions. However, it does have a lot of the features that other standalone extensions have. Web ChatGPT gives ChatGPT the ability to get data from search engines like Google, Bing, Yandex, and others. It also appears on the search engine page after entering a keyword at the right, providing you answers about the keyword and the sites used as source for the answer. This extension also adds a couple of prompt templates on top of ChatGPT. If you click on the extension icon, you can see all of them. there are prompts for copywriting, SEO, marketing, social media, and many other categories. The list is very big, so if you want to know what prompts are included, feel free to explore that at your own time by just installing that extension. AI Prompt Genius is an extension that will allow you to build your own library of custom ChatGPT prompts and organize those prompts in different folders and by using tags. You can add your prompts manually or also import prompts in bulk using CSV files, and you can also save your prompt and export as a CSV file. And then you can use that CSV file to import your prompt to other extensions or for other uses if you want to share it with someone else. And you can also do the same for this particular extension. If you find a collection of prompts online, you can also import that CSV file and you will have them available on ChatGPT with just a click of a button. After installing the extension, you just need to open ChatGPT and go into the input bar at the bottom and enter a forward slash and then type a term or the name of the prompt that you want to use, and then your prompt will appear. Then you can click on it, replace terms, and hit enter to get a response. Another useful extension is ChatGPT for Google. This one adds extra information during a search or the research process while using Google search. You can compare responses from different models like GPT-4, Google Bard, and Claude or others. This is a much quicker way to use ChatGPT instead of going back and forth between a search on Google and the ChatGPT page itself. You can get a short answer from AI and then elaborate or use it as a starting point to then expand your search by using articles, videos, and other content that you can use as sources for your own new piece of content or content research. Plus, you can also continue your conversation with the chatbot later by just opening up a new window. Replai is an extension for creating fast Twitter and LinkedIn replies using ChatGPT. You can save a lot of time while still giving meaningful and relevant replies. To use this extension, you would open Twitter or LinkedIn. Then you click on the post you want to reply or comment, choose your preferable reaction, and get AI-generated text. And then you can improve it and adapt it to your own tone of voice or send it as it is. The free plan is limited to 20 replies. It's still a very useful extension if you use both of these platforms regularly. You can get more replies by leaving a review and completing some other tasks that are 100% free. The next one is called Talk to ChatGPT, and as the name suggests, you can use voice to interact with ChatGPT by giving voice commands instead of writing. You can also listen to the outputs that you've got from your initial prompt. It works with your system language by default, and you can talk to it in a language and get a response in another if you want to. Once you open ChatGPT, you will see a box on the top right corner of the page. You can click on the Start button to start recording, but before starting, you may want to adjust some settings such as the language, speed, pitch, and others for better results. There's also another extension, which is Promptheus. This is another option for using voice with ChatGPT. For the best results, the extension recommends you use a Chrome-based browser. You'll then open ChatGPT, hold the spacebar, and start talking. You can customize some of the options in the top right by clicking on the Promptheus options to get the best results possible. And that's about it. It will do the same as the previous one, but it is just another alternative in case you don't like the previous one or you prefer this option. AIPRM adds a list of 3,600 plus curated prompt templates to ChatGPT. You have templates for copywriting, marketing, SEO, software as a service, software engineering, and more. There are tons of supported languages for your outputs. You can change the language in the output in field, and you can also change the tone. There are two options available, but if you want other tone options, they are only available in the paid version, which is a subscription. Creating your own prompts is also possible and easy to do. When using a prompt template, it will ask you for an input, so you would just select a template, then complete the description, which asks you for an input, and that input can be words or numbers. You can also check out a few ChatGPT desktop applications available on GitHub. I'm going to link one of them in the description, which allows you to add your own custom prompts there, and then you just enter a short phrase to get those working, and then you replace the terms, and it is pretty simple to use. They will be already inside of ChatGPT itself. However, that does mean that you need to create your own prompt to add to the ChatGPT app, or you can also check out my ChatGPT prompts template, which will be linked down in the description, where you can access a template that has custom prompts for social media, copywriting, content marketing, and much more. Then you can grab those, copy-paste those templates, or change them to suit your needs, and then you can use them on ChatGPT by just copy-pasting them. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, subscribe, and check out the AI or ChatGPT playlists for more content like this. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.